Welcome back, everyone. I'm Gwen Shapiro with Confluent, and this is Monitoring the Health of the Kafka Cluster. In the previous section, we explained why monitoring is so important. Now we will tell you how to monitor your cluster. The key thing that you really need is a real-time insight into what is the state of Kafka Cluster right now. Is it available? Is everything okay? So let's go through how Control Center does that for you. The first thing you'll want to look at is the circle in the upper left corner of the dashboard. This is what we call the check engine light for your cluster. If this circle goes red, we know that you have a problem with your cluster and it's time to investigate. You can see that this dashboard, it does not include every single metric in Kafka. It only shows the most important health metrics that we have. So you can see things like cluster utilization. Down below that you can see, are all my partitions available? Is replication all up to speed? And then you can also see the throughput on your cluster. So how many messages are you processing? It is in there because your boss is likely to ask you about that at least once a day. When you see something goes red, it is very likely to be under-replicated partition. In general, under-replicated partitions is something we see as the most important health metric to watch. The reason is that whenever something goes wrong with Kafka, no matter what it is, it will show itself as some under-replicated partition. So if you only have one metric to keep an eye on, this would be it. The reasons for under-replicated partition, it could be because a broker went offline, maybe intentionally you're doing planned maintenance, or maybe something just crashed. It could be a problem across the entire cluster, maybe lack of resources or lack of balance. It could be a problem with one broker. Maybe you have a hardware problem. Maybe someone started a very noisy application right next to it and took away all the resources. Whatever it is, this is the sign that you have to go in and start investigating. The way to proceed if you see under-replicated partitions is by drilling down into the metrics of specific brokers and specific topics. Look at the broker metrics and see, does one broker stand out to you? Is the throughput unusual? Do you see any sign of errors specific to that broker? And then also look at the topics, especially look if there are any subset of topics that only these have under-replicated partitions. In this case, you can actually drill down into the topic level and see where the problem comes from. If you drill down into a topic, you see a map of the partitions and the placement of replicas in the brokers, which allows you to look at in a single glance to see, is the under-replicated partitions limited to a single broker, which means that you can immediately know that something went wrong with the broker and investigate there. Or if they're all over the place, it is probably a cluster-wide kind of problem that you have to go and investigate network resources and the balance of workload across the cluster. But obviously, you're not going to sit there and look at the circle on the screen going red every moment of your life. You have work to do. So what you really want is to define alerts. Alerts in Control Center are made up of two parts. We have a trigger and we have an action. You define a trigger. If something happens, do something. In this case, if you have under-replicated partitions, send an alert. The action is usually an email. So if you have under-replicated partition, email the administrator, and this will usually go to something like pager duty, and you will get maybe a pager or SMS saying, oh, there is under-replicated partitions, and then you go in and start investigating. Don't create an alert for every little thing. Usually you want those high-level alerts that can cover a lot of things, and then when you get an alert, you have a chance to investigate. Way better than getting 15 alerts every time something goes wrong. I want to emphasize how important it is to set alerts for under-replicated partitions, being the most important metric. We have seen cases where customers had production Kafka clusters, and when we showed up and discussed them with them and took a look at the Kafka cluster, we discovered that actually maybe only 3 out of 5 brokers were even available on a production mission critical cluster. And the people running the cluster had no idea that this was the case. Without alerts, you really have no good chance of knowing when things go wrong, which puts you in a very risky position, right? There were 2 crashes away from losing the entire Kafka, and they wouldn't even have known that. You don't want to wait for the business to tell you Kafka is not there. You want to know way ahead of time. But of course, you don't want to just react to emergencies. You want to plan ahead. Your system is constantly growing. You're getting new use cases, and you need to know how to prepare for them. Some of the numbers on the dashboard indicate the utilization of the system. You see the network and thread pool usage, you see request latencies, you see the throughput, network utilization growing, and you see the disk utilization if you look at the log segment statistics for every broker. This gives you an indication of how close you are to the limits of the system. And you don't want to wait until you hit the limits. We usually recommend that you take action when you're maybe 60 or 70% to the limit. And the reason is that handling the growth of cluster takes resources itself. So if you wait until the last minute to add nodes to the cluster and to balance load, you may get to a point where it's actually quite painful to do so. So you want to plan ahead, stay ahead of the game, and do your management activities in the times that works for you and is comfortable for you, and not at a 3 a.m. emergency. We've seen how to monitor the health of one Kafka cluster, but in your organization, you probably have more than one. You probably have one for development, for tests, for production, one for very important messages, one for secure messages. You have to monitor all of them all the time. Control Center is capable of monitoring multiple clusters at the same time. You use the Dropbox on the upper right corner of the screen when you look at the dashboards. And it can also manage replication between the two data centers and keep both data and metadata in sync. Now that you know how to tell if Kafka is healthy, in the next section, we're going to discuss how to monitor end-to-end workflows.